YouTube, welcome back to another video. Guess who's back? Today I'm gonna be telling y'all my final thoughts on Casper's album, you know, as well as Bryson Tiller's album and Tory Lanez's album. You know, I'm not trying to waste any time, so let's just get into it, you know. With the Casper album, I feel like it's a really strong album. It's a really mature album. You know, I feel like a lot of people in the SA music industry weren't expecting such a strong album from him. You know, we knew it was going to be a nice album, but like on this level, like I think he surprised a lot of us. You know, even for it to be able to reach like the top 30 of the best albums in the whole world, Joe, you know, that's just a big thing, you know. So I feel like the boy really did his thing, you know. I feel like the album has a lot of layers to it. It has like everyone, it's for everyone, basically, you know. Everyone can take something from it, you know. I personally could have done without the Pop Smoke sounding songs, you know. And I also could have done without the Pro Kid feature, you know. I feel like that one was just the most disappointing song for me, because when I saw his name on the checklist, I thought that song was going to be something special, you know. And it was just very underwhelming for me, you know. So I could have done without the songs, those songs, you know. But other than that, like, that album is just a really strong album. I find myself going back to it a lot, you know, especially because of songs like Egyptian Cotton, Indota, and Friday Nights, which is just a vibe on its own, you know. It's just a vibe. And I also appreciate it because it has songs like, it has songs that are kind of worship songs that my mom could actually listen to, you know, because I played her one of the songs and she actually liked it, and she asked if this was Zola 7's album, and I told her no, you know. But she said it was actually a nice song, you know. He sounds proper. For the fact that she even recognized his voice was just like, you know. So I feel like for that simple fact, NG, it's just a big feat in my case, you know. So I'll probably give this album a really strong 8, you know. Because out of the 4 albums that we've waited for this year, you know, I think us as South Africans, we've all been waiting for Casper's album, a.k.a. Nasty C and Aries album, you know. I feel like those 4 are the most anticipated albums in SA right now. And having Nasty C and Casper drop their 2 albums, I feel like Casper has the strongest album so far, you know. I don't know about AKA's album, I don't know about Aries' album, but, you know, we'll just have to wait and see, you know. So I feel like for that simple fact, I'm just gonna give it an 8. And I'm gonna moving along swiftly. The Bryson Tiller's anniversary, guys. I think this one bothers me, guys. Like, it kingers me because I didn't want him to do this. You know, I feel like Trap Soul is an album that no one can recreate. No one can recreate how good that album was. That album is probably one of the most perfect albums to come out of the 2010s era, you know, in the last decade. Like, it's the best album by far, you know. A lot of people will agree with me, you know. So I feel like him trying to recreate that album, it'll never work. It's gonna be like, it's like what happened to Nas, you know. Like, Nas created arguably the best hip-hop album of all time, and he spent his whole career trying to recreate that album. It's not gonna work. It's not gonna work. And, you know, I feel like this album, he was trying to recreate that sound. I'm not saying it's a bad album, it's a really nice album, but like, at the same time, you can't put it in the same context as Trap Soul. You know, Trap Soul is just a whole nother beast on its own. You know, I feel like you trying to recreate that album is just going to be your own detriment. This should have just been part of the songs in this album. I feel like should have just been part of the deluxe version, you know. They should have just been the deluxe, then I would have been happier if it was just a deluxe or just another EP or something, you know. But I've read somewhere on the internet that he's also working on another album, so maybe these were just like, you know, just to celebrate 5 years of Trap Soul, you know. But for me, I'll just give it a simple six and a light six, between a six and a light seven, you know. That's what I'll give this album. Like, I listened to it once. I have like two good songs there that I like. I like Always Forever and some other one, the interlude. I forgot the name of the interlude, but there's an interlude in there. I think it's Timeless Interlude. That one is also proper. It reminds me of the Trap Soul sound, but still, like, it's not like there's no song that's like that can compete with like a Don't or Exchange, you know, and my personal favorite, which was Over Time, you know. None of them give me that strength or that sense of like, you know, I'm in my feelings, you know. So I'm just like, yeah, it is what it is, you know. I could have done without the album, but yeah, man. Moving along swiftly. Tory Lanez gave us his Daystar album, which was kind of a response to the whole situation with the Megan Thee Stallion. I don't want to talk too much about that situation because people are going to be looking at me sideways, you know. But me personally, because I'm such a big Tory fan, you know, I've been listening to Tory Lanez consistently for the last 2 years, bro. Like, every album he released, I listen to it back to back almost every day, bro. You know, and the album that's been in heavy rotation on my playlist right now recently has been Nas's New Toronto 3, you know, which I feel like is very underrated, and it has a lot of good songs there. Tory Lanez is rapping his ass off, you know. But also with the Daystar album, like, he just popped off for me. Like, he went off, he sounds very comfortable, he sounds very, I would say, sincere, but like at the same time, like, his raps are really real, you know, regardless of the situation. I wish like he had dropped this album under a different circumstance, you know. Like, under these circumstances, like, it's really tough to have such a nice album be degraded by the things that are happening in his personal life. So I feel like a lot of people, I feel like, in the internet are just following trend by saying the album is trash or whatever. Those people have never actually taken time to go listen to that album. And I'm looking at, and I know there's someone that's looking at me right now and being like, nah, nigga, that album is trash. No, you didn't listen to it. You didn't listen to it. You know you didn't listen to it. You know, y'all are just following trend, you know. But like I said, I'm not here to judge anyone. I'm not here to speak on the situation. All I'm going to say is that if you're a true music fan, then you know what it is. Then you know what it is, you know. So I'm just going to keep it short and say that album, I'm going to give it a serious 8. A very strong 8, because it's also been in heavy rotation on my playlist. I've been listening to it quite frequently, regardless of the situation. No one's going to tell me what to listen to. It's my music, nigga, you know. So, yeah. Besides that, guys, like, I feel like you can't expect me to stop listening to a person because of cancel culture, man. Like, I don't believe in that shit. Everyone makes mistakes, regardless of whether he's innocent or guilty, you know. You can't judge me, bro. Like, it's like if you were to find out today that, like, Samsung, you know, I'm just gonna make an example that Samsung maybe has like slaves that are working to make that company what it is. How many people have Samsung TVs at home and everything? Imagine if you were to find out today that Samsung has slaves or whatever working, you know. You're not gonna now throw away your TV, you know. Like, you already have the thing, you know. You've been supporting it for years now, so it's like, bro, you're not gonna throw away your TV. That's just the case. You're not gonna throw away your TV. That's how I feel like with Tory's music. Like, I can't just simply throw it away because this is someone I've been listening to for years, you know. So, yeah, man. I don't wanna talk too much on the situation. People are gonna be looking at me sideways. Like I said, smash the like button, smash the subscribe button. Thank y'all for watching. Keep subscribing, keep sharing, keep liking, keep commenting. I'm just gonna try my best to upload as much as I can, guys. But otherwise, I'll see y'all in the next video. I'm in the city with bitties, they showing their titties, they fucking with me. Pull up the document, Dominican shorties, we really be looking OD. Moncler coat in the NYC with a PYT, and she all on me. Cartier shades in the dark outside, but I only got them on cause I'm high OD. Move like Obama, I just bought a llama, I named it Osama, it solved all the drama. Just got a comment, spit that on my mama, cause being dead broke at a family trauma. I'm giving all these hood niggas hope, showing them niggas ain't gotta sell dope. Take a percentage to show you the ropes, business is business, you know how they go.